I missed you guys yesterday, but hey, let me get to the things that I understand better. Let's talk gossip. A lot did go down over the weekend, but not that much. But hey, someone has to do this job. My name is Tina Pierce-Warren. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Woo, we're finna have us a royal wedding. I told you last time. It seems that Komuntale and her beau, Obewabe, are actually moving things quite fast. Now, over the weekend, we were treated to images of the King of Toro, that's Komuntale's brother and younger brother at that, and the Queen Mother of Toro, and Habe, and some other random guy. I don't know who he was, but he must be important in the Toro kingdom or something. Anyway, they met each other. They shared the photos on social. I was like, wow. Like, she's serious this time. She took her time. She's actually very damn serious. So, in line with that, I have a couple of things I want to say to you, Komuntale. One, I hope this marriage lasts longer than the last one. Two, please make sure you don't have STDs before you move into this one. We're not going to share screenshots of what they're saying about you after. Three, we simply want to wish you happiness. I mean, your kingdom has been through so much in that department. So we just want to simply wish her happiness. What are we saying? It's not for my royalty, but we're just saying the STD situation, we don't want it to repeat itself. And I hope he's the one. I honestly do hope he's the one. Kubaluli watomera no gwambikopo. Whatever bad boy, no gwambikopo. This guy looks decent. He looks presentable. He looks like he has had an education. Nice. This time, let's have a dope wedding, not like a one you did like. You know what? Kongs Komuntale. I'm not going to say much. So, Jose Chameleon was on national television. You know what I mean by that. Boo child. He was on national television and he was explaining his truths to the different journalists that did come through because he held a, it was kind of like, was it a presser? Was it a conference? Which one was it? You know, but journalists were going to win a caller most of the time. Anyway, he was clarifying on so many things and I'm glad he did because I remember the last story I did about him. I was like, dude, clarify. So he came out, clarified on a couple of things, but it left me wondering. I have questions. One, he says, yeah, he's getting ready, the mayor situation. Yeah, he's getting ready, if he wants, Ajakwe Simbao. But better yet, he's like, if the pressure from the people amounts and it is really unbearable, I will definitely do a political office. And I'm like, okay, child, I see you. Then he goes like, I mean, I have run the music industry for 20 years. Really, a city should not be that hard. That's a part when I was like, you know what, Tina, not today. Joseph. Mayanja. Ooh, Joseph Mayanja Chameleone. I have so much faith in people. I have so much faith that everyone can be what they want to be, decide who they want to be at whatever given particular time. But you, running this here city, is one of those things I do not believe in. How? Why would you? You see, again, it goes back to the Robert, to the Chagulanyi effect. You know, that's the real Chagulanyi effect, where he came out, told everybody, you know, I'm going to stand. He did stand. He became a very good politician. Now, for some reason, every artist, every known factor is just saying, well, keyword here is people. Now, if I add power to the people, I am going to be given. No. Keyword here should be, can you serve? Can you serve to perfection? You've seen our... He keeps trying, but it's hard. And you are going to come out and tell me 20 years in the music industry is enough for you to think you can run a city, the capital city of this here country. I'm like, child, no. No, Chameleone. Bobby Wine has given so many people hope, which is good. But then again, in giving them hope, he has also turned some others into lumpens. Others have become hooligans. Others have started cutting. I'm not going to do this, but that was his truth though. So, Katumulinde, people, I'm under that pressure. I want to be among the citizens of this here beautiful country. Who is going to sit here when they swear him in as mayor and the first 100 days are going to be so much life? I want it to happen. So let's push. You know, let's push for Chameleone to be mayor. It's going to be interesting. Another thing he talked about was his house situation in the States. Now he came out and he's like, I did not leave Uganda. Mm-mm. Scholarship. That's when I was like, yes, you're winning on so many fronts. He says his kids got scholarships. He They had to travel. He had to move with them just to get them into the system and try, you know, settle them in. I'm like, that's sweet. That's good stuff, man. Big up. Abamu mulina abana ngati baina chebasobola kola, but he's that talented and his kids are equally talented. It's a good thing, right? Then he about to get on some bullshit and go and tell us how he bought a house. I don't know. What is Sokanemvu Mafaba na Uganda? What is so hard for you to go on Google, until you love phones a lot, go on Google and Google about these different countries. Go and Google about real estate in America. Go and Google about things that these celebrities tell you. Namwene mugendera ko gaiwa peyaguze nyumba. Did he buy it? Is it mortgaged? Is it leased? Because I know for a fact you can't afford to buy a house in a day, Chameleone, regardless of your 20 years in this industry. I'm just, I can't. You're going to be paying mortgage for the next 50 years. Even your kids will pay that mortgage. So for you to come out and tell us, sisobola kulaga receipt yage to 34 million people, it's because you don't got a receipt. You got an agreement. Two different things. A receipt is different from an agreement. I'm just saying, let's clarify on these things. Because these things now piss me off. Because Ugandans, mugena ne movie, kumamo, omulido, omulido, gai yaguze motoka, gai yaguze chino, gai yaguze... Same nonsense. What's this car guy's name? Go back when you're kumina satu na aramka. Chris Evans came out last week. I saw the story and I was like, I will not embarrass myself to this year level. He's like, video yange cost me 90 million in atunde nyanya. Really, Chris? You lied to us the first time. You're doing it the second time. Oh yeah, what do you want us to do for you? Do you want us to first look for you like an hour, pull him back? And then he tells us he shot it in Pretoria. Then I tell the photos are showing it is somewhere in Gayaza at a horse ranch. I'm like, people, don't take in everything that these people give you. Before you take it in, go do your due research. Ask, find out. Because we're out here looking like the dumbest country. When I see some of the comments on these different stories on different platforms on social media, I'm like, if there's someone in another country reading this ish, I think he's sitting there like, damn. These people are dummies. I'm just saying, let's do our due research. So anyway, Kamili came out, those he clarified and all of that. I'm not taking an achiru wako. Have a tit. Let me know. The shenanigans between Cindy and Sheba, the words that were said, the stupidity of it all, how it escalated from zero to go to 100 real quick, and I'm like, chingange chindazi bo chite kambekin powder munji. This is that story. Anyway, so different celebrities. Vinka came and they called her male artist. So Irene came out and she was on national television again. And she goes like, I don't think I'm going to use it in the light and line that Cindy meant to use it. But yeah, I put some respect on Cindy as an artist without management. She's like, Manange, it's so hard. You have to put, you know, respect on us. I do everything with my sister, Netuzunga, all my businesses, blah, blah, blah. I'm looking at her like, it was a choice. You made a good choice. But I don't think that every management is like that. Perhaps you should have tried different management. You can't disregard that everyone who is under management is just a fool. Okay, some of them are fools, but they are fools who are going places. I'm just saying. Let's just be objective here. Anyway, she put it like that. Like, Khalifa Aganaga apparently has hopes, dreams, thoughts, faith and belief. All those things that every man needs. Mbwagenda kola concert. Now, not to disregard the fact that he's actually an artist. When was the last time he gave us a song? The one with Chameleone. I don't say it is old already, was it last year? If you're a real mainstream artist, you're supposed to be giving us ish every 3 weeks. I'm just saying. Anyway, here's what else is going to do a concert. And then someone who was seated next to me goes like, so T, let's explain this to me. I call a concert. And he again don't go attending. Because he has like about 12 songs. Huh? 12. Three songs, eh? So are we going to be doing curtain raisers? Are we going to talk at the COVID stage? What are the, who is going to show up? Management Nabanakidininga Arena. I mean, why I'm asking these questions and you guys think I'm being rude or petty? It's because at times I want artists to really wear their options. Artists believe in just being artists. You need to also look at the financial constraints of your trade, of your skill, or you need to take mathematics. Now, you know what? It's been my 10 minutes of the day. I'm not even going to. I cannot. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook, ScoopOnScoop, and at TinaFierce1. Like and follow the pages. On Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H, and I'll catch you all on YouTube in the comments section. I don't want to go full savage on you, eh? But I'm around your comment sections. I may just be that person who is being petty and abusive, if you know what I mean. I'm just saying. For now, though, I'm out.